The James Bay Athletic Association was formed in 1886 by a small group of Victorians who loved playing sports. In the early 1880s, there was a four-team local baseball league playing games at Beacon Hill Park. Dan O'Sullivan, who was born in Victoria and educated at St. Louis College, lived in the original Bay area and organized this James Bay Baseball Club. In 1889, James Bay versus the Maple Leafs was the feature game at the opening of the new fenced-in Caledonia Park at Simcoe and Government Streets. It was that ball team that led to the formation of the James Bay Athletic Association, which was formally chartered that same year. For 125 years, JBAA members have been engaged in rowing, basketball, baseball, soccer, track and field, boxing, tennis, lacrosse, hockey, and especially rugby. By 1891, the members had built this two-story clubhouse and floating boathouse overlooking Victoria's Inner Harbour. Rowing became the first sport in which JBAA members excelled. Among their early wins was this stunning solid silver four-oars trophy won during Diamond Jubilee celebrations in 1897. JBAA runners also racked up some impressive wins. Here's a bay running down Fort Street near Stanley, leading the 1909 Victoria Marathon. Four JBAA athletes made headlines in 1912. Bill Day was our island's top mile racer. Al Davies was the Pacific Northwest amateur boxing champ. Sprinter Hal Beasley and Canada top middle distance runner Tom Gallen competed for Canada at the Stockholm Olympics. But it was rowing that produced most of JBAA's wins prior to World War I. In 1895, JBAA's Big Four, with O'Sullivan as stroke, won their first of six straight North Pacific Rowing Association championships. That all changed when World War I broke out. Many of JBAA's best joined the thousands who answered the call for their country, and sports were reduced to low levels. Many outstanding athletes, including JBAA's Tom Gallen, paid the supreme sacrifice. In all, 86 bays enlisted in the armed forces, including Dr. T.A. Briggs, whose son Tillman went on to become one of JBAA's most influential members. After the war, JBAA rowers picked right up where they'd left off, winning the North Pacific title again in 1927. In 1935, Bay's rowers included John Rockingham, who later led the Royal Hamilton Light Infantry in Normandy, and who in 1950 led Canadian forces in Korea. In 1936, the JBAA 8s were race winners at Vancouver's Golden Jubilee. World War II saw rowing fade again, and while reviving periodically in recent times, it has never again returned to the halcyon days of early years. Rugby reached the shores of Vancouver Island in 1877 when England's Royal Navy Fleet played a team of local athletes at Beacon Hill Field. Some of those players would go on to become JBAA members, and more than 125 years later, our bays still take the field in the traditional navy blue. By 1892, JBAA was regularly playing sides from visiting British ships. Initially, JBAA played home games at Beacon Hill Park. Then island rugby interest began to dwindle away until the James Bay Athletic Association reformed a team in 1908 and played out of Oak Bay Park. Also in 1908, Byron Boss Johnson, who would later become Premier of British Columbia, joined JBAA rugby and lacrosse teams. In 1910, Bill Day joined the Bays. JBAA rugby at McDonald Park started in 1934, where it continues to this day. The Bays clubhouse, which was initially on Belleville Street, moved to the Gorge in 1928. In the late 30s, it was on Robert Street in Vic West. And then, after some years in coach and manager Alex McDonald's basement and at the Pro Pats Legion, in 1967, we moved to our present location at McDonald Park. Women have played a significant athletic role at JBAA, initially in tennis, badminton, basketball, and rowing. In the late 1970s, interest in rugby came to the fore, and a women's rugby team under JoJo Wild's leadership has represented JBAA well for much of the past decade on and off. The zenith of women's sports, however, at JBAA was reached in 1983-84 when this Barry Robbins-coached JBAA soccer side won the BC Championships and narrowly missed a national crown. But it's rugby that has truly defined JBAA over the past 125 years. And it's in rugby that our club has built a record unequaled in Canadian sporting history. JBAA has won a record 23 Rounsfell Cup BC titles, including 7 in a row in the 1970s, an achievement that's likely never to be equaled. JBAA has won a record 54 Barnard Cup Island titles, including a run of 11 years in a row starting in 1972. JBAA was the inaugural winner of the Bays Vikes Challenge Cup established by Ian Stewart last season. And JBAA also won the Canadian Club Championship in 2006, the last year it was held. The origin of this legacy of champions stems from a long history of great leaders. And they didn't just serve for a year or two. Harry Helmicken, for whom the local street is named, was president for 21 years. John Cameron was in charge for 12 years, and R.F. Taylor was president for 19. If we were to single out one leader to stand above the rest, it would be Tillman Briggs. Tillman coached the Bays to the record 7 straight BC crowns starting in 1973, and added 3 more, plus a Monterey tournament win before his retirement in 1990. Some great players had Tillman's back in those years. Guys like Bob Overgaard, Les Underwood, Benj O'Connor, Hans DeGoody, Gary Johnson, and Barry Robbins, to name but a few. Continuing the tradition of strong leadership in more recent times, Mick Eckhart, Gary Johnson, and JBAA's current coach, Pete Rushton, have added another 6 notches to JBAA's BC championship belt. But JBAA has also lost some great players whose lives were cut way, way too short. Eight of our athletes gave their lives during the wars. Scott, Austin, Boggs, Gallagher, Pilkington, Rich, Sinclair, and Taylor. Courtney Walls was murdered in 1997. His memory has lived on in annual rugby games or golf events that bear his name. In 2005, we lost Courtney Taff, a major blow to women's rugby at JBAA and across Victoria. And also in Chuck Shergold, we lost a teammate and friend. We also remember Drew Denniston, Jack Patrick, who died on the field playing the game he loved, and Nick Mathers, who was killed by a drunk driver in 2006. Looking back over the years, a national record 43 Bays have taken the field in Canada's colors, starting with Frank Skilling in 1937 and carrying through to DTH Vandermeer and Sean White this year. See how many you can recognize.
Don't give us nothing.
game by game, season by season, decade by decade, for 125 years from 1886 until today, literally thousands of athletes have given their best to create the amazing sporting legacy that is the James Bay Athletic Association. Club historian Lou Madley summed it up well in the book he wrote for our 100th anniversary. It is in clubs like JBAA that young people's characters are developed, a spirit of community is created, and the qualities of amateurism nurtured, these qualities being the very essence of a healthy and viable society. Huddy Huddy Bays.